Listening audience. We're so happy to be back with you on a Friday today because, Maureen, we've had ups and downs, you know, and we made it to Friday. I want you to remember that you're listening to WHPRS. Did I do that right? Located in Highland Park, Michigan, you know, the capital of Detroit. We want you to listen in. We want you to participate. And please have your pencils and paper, because Maureen and I can't give you a pencil nor a paper. It's not like that. You can't say, Zoom me up, Charlie. So I hope you're ready to participate and use those numbers that are listed below. 313, I cannot see. 4336. Maureen. I cannot see them. Usually you better know that those glasses hanging down beside you somewhere. But again, welcome. And let's get on. Let's go. We live in a peaceful people, Maureen. No, you wait a minute. It's like that man that is. Wait a minute, Dan Gilbert. He's a An organization award, which is Michigan Welfare Rights Organization, and that's what we were given. Yeah, that's what we were given our award to. And I'm telling you, it was good to be there because we thought we didn't know nobody there, and then all of a sudden we began to recognize several people. But the sister that put our name in, I mean, she brings tears to your heart. I mean, she's tremendous.
See, I mean, it's an honor.
I don't see
her give it to me, and I'll say what it is.
And she, and you know what? I know her from being in the community working hard, being out there on the picket line with us and everything. And, you know, I want to say to her again, thank you for recognizing our organization and the type of work that we do. It's through people like yourself who have been on the picket line with us, who have been out there in the rain, sleet, snow, the heat, and what have you, that this is so appreciative that we would get this from one of our peers. So the Afro-American organization that puts this on recognize people that have worked not only in the community, those that have and worked in the community, those that have given back to Mother Africa as far as, you know, the, their little salary that they might get or what have you, they send money back there to try to upgrade certain things that need to be upgraded. And not only that, they do it in a diocese, and the diocese is us. We are family and stuff like that originally came from Africa. And they call that those that are lost are not living in Africa, that we living in the diocese. You know, I meant to look that up a long time ago, but I remember, you know, that's how we were recognized when we went to Africa. But
the majority of folks,
it was Pat Maureen all the way out the door.
But there were folks from Nigeria, folks from Ghana.
Oh, okay.
And, you know, I never met anybody from Cameroon.
The food was tremendous.
The conversations were really wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
We stayed a lot.
And all of us, you know,
really wonderful family.
Mm-hmm. Some of our members joined us in this because this is a platform, Michigan Welfare Rights. And the outstanding work that our membership have been doing, and that is, we had Sister Gwen, the one that runs the office. We had Sister Tawana Mars, who also works in the office. And Tawana recognized a lot of people that she knew and was all over the place taking pictures. It was so glad to have her. And then we had Sister Ann Wall, you know, who's one of our instructors, you know, teachers, and in college teacher. You know, she couldn't keep still neither. She said, this has been a tremendous event, and I needed something like this tonight. And then we had little Valerie, I always say, Valerie Baker. And Valerie said she learned a lot, you know, because we were not aware of this particular organization. The greetings were so warm, Maureen. Oh my God, Mother Flump. Mother of Welfare Rights right now.
Okay.
Now, yeah. Oh, yeah. Caitlin and Ryder were there. Anybody else from Welfare Rights? No. Yeah, it was, but we all were at two different tables because it was quite a bit of us there.
Let's say something right quick about, I'm looking it up.
His name?
Dr. Ola.
Yeah, Dr. Ola works at WC3. And apparently he has been like the father to a lot of the folks coming in here from Africa. Just like we migrated from the south, a lot of folks coming in here, and he helps them not only to find jobs, but to get an education. And all the people that went up there, even from the, from different organizations and stuff like that, you know. Yeah, village. They were there. Oh, my Lord.
This was a dinner with music.
All the way through.
The entertainment was by a group called Afrobeat.
And
Afrobeat started playing. Well, let's see, we got there at 6. They were starting playing about 4 to 7.
Mm-hmm.
And didn't stop till after 8.
That's right.
They didn't take a break or anything. And it was a wonderful.
The only time they took a break, Maureen, was when they were through. And they went back there and eat. Some eating, and then they got ready to leave.
They didn't take no breaks. You know, guy with the saxophone, that brother,
he can blow
between an alto sax, and then he had a tenor sax,
right?
And then he would switch them up.
And then they had the drum.
And the drummer never stopped for at least an hour.
That beat went on and on and on and on and on.
And it was fabulous. Mm-hmm. We have pictures I got of Tawana. I'll send them to you already.
I got some.
That was something. So
That was a good night out, you know, because, you know, we kept saying, dude, we were tired. And once we walked into that room, oh, my goodness, it was wonderful. Oh, Maureen was driving me up the wall. Maureen was trying to figure out how she could buy every outfit in there. That looked like Yotas. It was beautiful. She was beautiful. And the man looked good, too. Mm-hmm. Down to the babies. They were beautiful. Mm-hmm. In fact, one last thing, but we want to say thanks to Dr. Olar and Alan for the recognition. It just encouraged you to go on and do more work. I forgot.
Let's move on.
Let's move on until I remember.
All right, I talked with Cynthia last night on the phone. And she called right away because she's concerned about this $14,000 of workers losing their jobs. Mm-hmm. So
just in time.
Mm-hmm. You know, those who are making seats and those who are making seat jobs and all those ancillary jobs and whatnot. So, workers gave General Motors the bailout. If they got $140 million worth of tax breaks, all these things happened. And Mary said what she said. And then what happened now with the government? Everybody's upset. We all feel bad just before Christmas. You hear this kind of mess. This is an outrage. And the very next report, Mary, the stock market went up.
Yes.
They were happy that people were losing
their jobs.
So probably know they did. Oh, my God.
Maureen, you know, it's always the same old. But, you know, what changes is we have to keep up with the economic situation that we're living, forced to live up under. And that is, this government supports the capitalists. They squeeze out of us all the time. We don't have but a few pennies, but they come and take those pennies. GM, and I remember that so much. I was working at uh, what was the name of the, Michigan Legal Services, right before that, the people in Hamtramck was calling for attorneys and all to come over there and represent them against GM at that time. They took a stand, and now here we, those same people probably dead and gone, some of them, but at the same time, here we are now. GM should be made to pay back to the people of Hamtramck, back to the people of Michigan, the monies that they have soaked away from us. They need to be, people need to demand that money be given back. So what I think about it, I think it's highway robbery without a pistol.
I'm calling you on the air. Thank you for waiting. Thank you for calling us. Welfare rights.
Good afternoon. Most of the area where that, Mother's Spring?
Yes.
Detroit.
Yes, we know that.
Most of us in Detroit. I grew up over there.
Uh-huh. So you remember that.
You talked about
it. I moved to California.
You talked about the area.
I moved to California and came back. I said, I'm going to see my old hood. And I tried to cry. It looked like an Air Force base.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Completely gone. I did research. General Motors had promised they was going to rehab all that neighborhood.
That's right.
They never had three shifts going. And over the decades, the city council gave them tax break after tax break after tax break. And
never made them pay none of it.
But in the bottom renaissance, that cost almost $1 billion to build for $40 million. Their thing was, we're going to move out the country. We're going to move out of Michigan. If y'all don't do this, y'all don't do that. And you know what? Their executive board is in New York. That Larry Bond and all those people, whatever name, they be running game from New York.
Mm-hmm.
This Detroit edifice is just for, to keep up with this Motor City crap.
Yeah.
You know that we the Motor City capital and all that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And
it's a mess, isn't it?
It's a mess. And that city council,
pitiful, just pitiful.
They could have stopped a lot of this tax break crap.
They could have stopped this.
Well, Colin, what I think is that the political education that's necessary to get people to take the right stand, most folks don't have it. And
the individualist
usual method of dealing with stuff is to privatize, or if it's the usual deal to offer tax breaks, or if it's the usual deal, to do whatever it is that they've done in the past, and clearly it doesn't work. It's just
the new attorney general coming in now, I'm better.
Yeah.
I want you to get on their behind and sue them for running game on our tax money.
It ain't gonna happen at all until we write her a note and say we need to meet with you.
Yes, that's how we got to start. Yes.
Call her when we get that band and everything ready to go on there to Lansing.
Are you gonna be with us?
Yes, ma'am. Check on that.
Paul. Thank you for waiting, and thank you for calling us. Well, for rights, you are on the air.
Yes. Good evening.
Good evening.
You know, it's a shame the race the end of doing people. You know, they've been around and come to president, the city council, and all of them have been around about this. They didn't just wake up yesterday morning, put that on the table, and lock that.
That's
the people. Yeah, they all of them know the president, and they just make them speeches like they go, come back taking their, what they call them, the tax break for them. But that's a done deal. They knew about this all the time. They all got their hands in the cookie jar. And then another thing I heard you mention about Marie Thornton,
yes.
What is going on with that situation?
I don't know about it, Carl, before you just said something about it. We're going to have to look into it and see what's going on.
Right, okay. Mm-hmm. I live in the Woodbridge here. You know, and place me there. So whatever she needs to do, we need to support her. Because like
you said, yeah, that's right.
She's always supported our children and the food of our...
We
will, yes.
Okay, so this bad time for them to be laying people off, you know, after we, a lot of them GM people and gave up the benefits.
You know what? I think the workers should be in the forefront of this, but you know, got laid off, and we'd be there right along with them. But we need to demand our tax money back.
Right.
Yeah, you give it, and it has to come back. The tax money have to come back with interest.
Right. You know, if the city council, you know, they need to give it all up and give it back.
And being paid by y'all.
When you gonna be sitting there for summer? What's that song? Have yourself a merry little Christmas.
Say no. you're not going to lay these workers off. And put their hammers down and whatever and say, we're going to stay out here until our brothers, sisters, and brothers are rehired.
Now, let's get deeper into this. The reason that they're talking about they have to ship these five kids down Lordstown, transmission shop, and have them, I mean, in their training. And I'm not going to get the, one tank and one assembly, transmission, I can't call hand driving, the one in Ontario, and there's another one in Kentucky. Now, here's my thing. They don't want to make passenger cars, and they've already got, I don't know how many hundreds of thousands. Signaling lights all over the country, and they can't get nobody's buying them. Look like the first thing you would do is to lower the price of the car,
yes,
so that people can buy them. Like that'd be the first
that
thing
is common sense, Maureen, and they run it all. That is outright common sense, but their thing is profit.
Hundreds of thousands of cars, mm-hmm. You know, so, you know, that'd be the first thing. I'll call on you, then they should call you. Okay. Call your own head.
Hello?
Yes,
hello.
Oh, yeah.
How are you?
Fine.
That's what, Miss Taylor.
Yes?
I just sent someone out to your school Monday to see you. Bill, you know who they are.
Okay.
But they're going to tell you that I called this Friday. And I'm going to let you take care of a gift that I'm giving to your school.
Okay. Don't call her till 10 o'clock. I have to, because I have to watch if God will travel. They're going to be alive every Monday. So as soon as Paladin goes off, then I go to work, okay? And then I'll be there at 10 o'clock, and then I'll never go home till 6 or 7. So come on, send that present, okay?
Okay, I sure will.
All right, then.
Thank you so much.
Oh, my God. I have to deal with. For years, I've had to deal with it.
Those restrooms, you already know how they turn out.
Yeah, every last one of them.
Oh, you on here. You've been so patient.
Yeah, I know. After we got so many politicians, they're telling people to vote during election time. And what I can't understand, why we have so many politicians that we put in office, and then when they get in office, they be bought and paid. Can you answer that for me, sister?
We vote not based on people's longevity or people's practice. We vote on those little cards that people will vote if you're a lifetime member of the NAACP, if you're a lifetime member of the Girl Scouts or the Boy Scouts of America, if you're a lifetime member of the Church of What's Happening Next Week, you know, those kinds of things, and we don't know anything about your practice or if you're related to somebody that was already in office. So instead of preparing and grooming your mind to take seats, grooming folks, Mary, training people, getting people ready to be mayor, people ready to be council, people ready to be president, you know, we would not beat these candidates. These are not the ones we would have selected, but these are the ones we have to vote with. So that's why that happens, and it's going to keep on happening until we make a decision.
Okay, we're not going to let this nonsense go down.
We're going to run this. These Democrats and these Republicans and these independents, are they just going to keep, you know, Harvey Santana? And I knew him when he first got ready to go into office, and he was so involved and whatnot. And then I'm not sure what happened. And then it became term limited. I never could see any of the things that he was able to do. And I mean, in the beginning, he was very divided and focused. And then when he was term limited, I looked, and his name was on the ballot again, Mary. And I thought he was term limited. It turns out it was his wife who was running. And I didn't know anything about her. And then as we started to ask questions about stuff, the only thing we could find was that there is no answer. She's a good person, and she might be, because she comes from the Santana household. That's not the way we should be electing people for different offices.
We have to, We have to train people. And within that training, they have to have knowledge of what is really going on and why. And what then would you do to help with the community to stop some of this nonsense? What do you think about water? Don't come telling me, well, if you didn't pay your bill, you shouldn't have none. No, that's not what we're looking at. We have a particular program that we will address to these candidates. And if it does not fit what our program is about, then you can't get our vote.
And there it is, Paula. You've been patient. Thank you for waiting. And thank you for calling us. Welcome right to our last 15, 10 minutes. Go. 20 minutes. I can't hear you. Paula, you there? Paula, thank you for waiting. And thank you for calling us. Welfare Rights. You're on there.
DetroitNews.com. Cummings is ready to bring Snyder back before Congress over Flint.
Good, good.
I'm just hoping there's some kind of like 100 and so much.
Yeah, he needs to be put out under the prison.
I'm so tired of these other guys getting away with murder.
Yes.
Mayhem, austerity. Thank you for taking my call.
All right, thank you so much. Yeah. And that's how folks want to figure out how individuals get elected. And that's how it happens. You know, you got these candidates that are backed by this party or that party without any, have done any work in the community. You know, these are just jobs.
Oh, yes, they have done some work.
It's jobs.
They've done the kind of work that if they should make a mistake while they're in the office, that they can't be handled for that, you know, because they were doing their due diligence for the community. And that's a bunch of crap. All these folks out here that have stolen from us, our community, each one of these emergency managers also need to serve some time.
Calling you on the air. Thank you for waiting. Thank you for calling us. Welfare Rights, you are on here.
I have to follow up. You mentioned all those cars that they can't sell.
Yes.
You know what they're going to do with them, don't you?
Yes.
They're going to smash them up.
How crazy is that?
They're going to smash them up. Decades ago, California made General Motors force them to build a certain amount of electric cars.
Yeah.
And then General Motors soon went up to courts in California lost. And General Motors destroyed 10,000 plus electric cars.
That's insane.
We're dealing with devils here.
Well, I don't even know if you call that devil. Yes, it can be a devil and just plain insane. You know, some things just don't make any sense, but I do remember days when milk was about to expire. The milk is no good after tomorrow's date. And rather than take the milk away or charge 10 cents for a gallon, I've seen where people took that milk out to the curb and threw it away. That's just, you know, demonic kinds of activities. There's some right that got all these cars all over the place. Sell them for
a
dollar, right?
So now
it's not going down from there. You know, many people need cars, you know. Yes. This is crazy. Paula, thank you for that point of view. All right, now. Paula, you're on the air. You've been waiting, and thank you for calling us. Welfare Rights. We're down to our last 16 minutes.
Thanks for picking up.
Good afternoon. Yes, sir.
I just want to make a suggestion since you're talking about the water a little bit. I recently removed the galvanized pipe in my basement.
Yeah.
When I looked through that pipe, I couldn't even see straight through it.
That's right.
You know, and if you tap on the pipe, you're going to see some rust coming out.
Mm-hmm.
I suggest that we need to get a galvanized pipe removal program started.
Mm-hmm.
I know everybody can't afford it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know how it can be done. But I'm telling you, it is very important.
That should be on the backs of the state and the local cities.
That's an idea.
The federal government
yeah.
should be a part of it also, where they would help get these galvanized pipes here. And that's more
yeah.
jobs, too. That's a job creator.
I'm not 25. But I know exactly how to do it, and so I would never be involved. They would never hire me for those outreach. But we take some blood by the simplest and easiest thing in order to do that. On the spirit is love. They need to get some type of out.
That's right.
Well,
Carla, thank you very much for sharing that information. We appreciate you. Oh, you're on air. We're down to our last 15 minutes. You're on air.
How you doing?
I'm good. Hey, how you doing?
You know, you talk Jim and stop out in the east. And they have to stop and get burnt, they can't see it. And all they're going to do is recycle them.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. A lot of it has to do with insurance.
What do you mean?
Car insurance.
I know, but how do you relate it to? What do you mean?
Well, you got people who believe in their car.
That we're facing is happening all around the country. And that we need to educate our workers more. Just
right.
With that simple, very simple, but to the point, example that you use, they need to be able to understand that and the relationship of that to their family, being able to put some food on the table, and how they need to unite with their neighbors and everybody else
exactly.
And put a heart on this mess.
$5,000 for us. $15,000 or $20,000 car, and the $5,000 includes your insurance.
And that's better than that.
We could solve this in a week.
Not only that, I'm gonna say this, Maureen. That M1 train downtown, it should be servicing the community. But all they want to service is
people.
Huh?
That's too much like running.
Well, we know that, but you are so right.
So these kind of people that are in these positions are greed.
That's right.
Your vision is shared by Marion and I both. You keep that vision, because we're going to see if we can sharpen that vision up and figure out how to make the world that we live in the way you and I see it, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you for calling. Stay on.
I love you, ladies. Yeah. Yeah,
thank you.
Love you too.
Thank you, bye. Carla, you're on the air. We're down to our last 10 minutes. Go.
Yes, I called in a couple of weeks ago, the week before Thanksgiving, about all the problems I encountered to get down to the city county building.
Yes, I remember that.
To pay my property tax. I want to just say to everyone, make sure you check your bill to make sure that they validate that you're paying. That's all I went through. I didn't look at it when they handed that sheet back. You know how it's the third of it at the bottom, they rip it off.
Yes.
You know, for the city.
Saying no one should be making more than $15 an hour. And the first ones we're talking about are the legislators.
Well, we try to get
people. I know, but that don't stop us from doing anything.
Yeah, I agree. But I was so stunned when I heard that. And then all I could think of is I connected that just like the caller just did moments ago. You know, I connected this brand of thinking, you know. You remember how we got Florence Robert and went down to the Detroit City Council to fight with Victor Ricardo.
Oh,
and he kept saying, no, I'm not going to agree to any kind of waterfront building plan. No, I won't agree. No, I won't agree. And then he came back one day and said, you know, I really thought about this. I found the Lord. You know, and yes, I would like to work with you on this because I think it is a good idea. And we thought, oh, okay, we've convinced him. It turns out, you know, he was the guy with the key to the hen house, and he was actually the wolf. We knew he was the wolf, but he turned out to be even the bigger wolf. So we tried to tell people, you know, don't be told by these enemies that say they want to start working with you. And when this came up, we are going to allow $15 an hour in 2030. And we also are working on new legislation, Mary, to make it impossible to have that legislation put on the ballot between now and 2030 for you to vote for that. We're going to make it impossible. You will not be allowed to put that on for a referendum, and people will not be able to vote for that. And so the only thing, and Paul, I'm coming right to you, the only thing I can think of, Mary, is that when the GM workers, Chrysler workers first, Ford workers, you know, get these offers. And if you just, Master knocking at your door, and you open the door, and Master said, look, I want to be your friend, and I need you to send your little sister out here, and I'm going to bring her back in 2-3 days, but I need her to come up. And then after that, Master knock on the door, what you want to those biscuits you've been making, you know, you made 2 dozen, you need 2, and take the rest of them and put them in this basket. those other bitters, you've been doing some wonderful things with sweet potatoes. I want you to bring all of that out and put it on the doorstep. What I'm going to do is I'm going to come and stay in your house. And everything is going to be all right because I want you to know I do respect you. And I really think you're very smart. Now I'll be sleeping in your bed and with my gun. And that's what this sounds like when General Motors trail workers look, I mean, Cat Springs. Okay, Master. I need you all to give up your benefits. Okay, Master. I need you to send your little sister out to the side and, you know, we'll keep her for 2-3 days. Yes, sir, Master. And now, all of it cracked and hit the fan, and everybody's angry. And, you know, what's that song? You knew I was a sinner before you took me in. All of you on here, we're down to our last 5 minutes. All of you on here.
I called back because I just had a quick observation today.
Go ahead.
I'm a guy who has a sign picking up on the street now, Reverend Linda Anthony.
Okay,
so I guess that's been paying it up forever.
And where is it? On Otter Drive and what?
Otter Drive in Southfield.
Okay.
You know, that's where his large church is, and he's got so many acres of land in it.
Yes.
He had a sign up that he's going to build $500,000, I believe, condominiums and whatever. And now they will, I've heard before, they're trying to change Otter Drive to Reverend Anthony. But today, I'll put signs up, you know, above that street.
I live in that area. I'm going to go down that street to now so I can take a look.
That's not the being private, I guess.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
You know, so, Marion, at the end of the day, you know, I feel bad about these workers that just got this news and just for the holidays and you brought this up, taxes and do all kinds of things. Do you have any ideas, property taxes and all this kind of stuff? And here we go. All I can think of is Mary Bell. On TV with her beautiful stud diamond earrings, and I think about her and then the stock market just happy, grinning. You know, we're going to lay off some workers, and that means this company is going to be more profitable. And that's what we're about, the business of profits and not people's lives. You know, we need a vision, Mary. What kind of vision do we need?
We need a vision that we know we can live in a society that we don't have to worry about transportation, Maureen, health care, education, food on the table for our children, and to be able to have leisure time.
Carla, you're the last one. You got about 10 seconds quickly.
Yes, Maureen, I'm Mrs. Taylor.
Yes.
This is my Christmas gift. I want to give everybody that's listening. Go to GMC.org. Anyone that's a CNA that has gives $100 a blood, they can become a patient care assistant or a patient care technician. They're hiring on the spot as we come.
GMC.org.
BMC.
Oh, okay. BMC. You're talking about Detroit Medical Center.
Medical Center, right, yeah.
Got it. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you much.
You're welcome. To bye-bye.
All right, Mary, well, you have 5 seconds to say goodnight.
Oh. I'm looking forward to seeing each and every one of you next week. If I'm not sitting up here with you next week, Maureen, it's because
I'll be back.
I should be back. I might be in Ann Arbor because Kadisha just was realized that she's got a award coming.
Work it up.
Listen at this. Good night, and I hope to see you next week.
All righty. I don't know what else we can say. Mary and I have had a conversation in front of you today, and we heard about the white missionary that got shot in the Bible and went back anyway. We heard about the United African Community Organization who is recruiting, trying to get some more members. They all didn't want to forget. I want to read this. WHPR TV 33 can now be seen on FireStick. You can download WHPR-TV now. You can call, you can text, you can email, you can use all your social media outlets to tell your family and your friends in Chicago, Mary, in New York, Mary, in Washington, Mary, in Georgia, in Africa, Paris. We can be seen all over the world from now on because we have this device now called FireStick. WHPR-TV now. For more information, as we go over there.